Hello everyone! In this video I will introduce you SNMP Management Information Base. We will revise mine building blocks, cover MIB hierarchy tree, file basics, and look on command line query example. In previous video we were introduced to SNMP mine components like manager and device on which SNMP agent runs. In this video we will look onto agent database and objects identifiers. MIB is database module. It organizes object identifiers hierarchically, which can be represented in a tree structure that has individual ID and name. This tree structure contains all the manageable features of all products arranged in it. Object identifiers are represented by strings of numbers separated by dots. There are two types of managed objects, scalar and tabular. Scalar objects defined by a single object instance and will have zero at the end. Tabular objects defined by multiple related object instances that are grouped in MIB tables. Two identifiers are provided as example. They can be represented in numbered format and named format. In this case, system name is scalar identifier. All proprietary MIB files are using private tree, where each manufacturer has his own unique ID assigned. Every device that supports SNMP must also support MIB version 2. It defines different management groups. System defines a list of objects that pertain to system operation, such as system uptime, system name. Interfaces keeps track of status of each interface and monitors such things as interface state, interface errors, bytes received, bytes sent, and so on. MIB file basically is text file which defines all dependencies and objects. In example you can see interface MIB definition that is shown in upper left corner. Then there are different object imports specified. From specifies from which MIB file objects are imported. Those are the dependencies which are required to use named queries. Numbered queries are possible without MIB file. Application which uses MIB files imports all dependencies and creates database structure. Down the file, object specification follows. Each object has his own name, type, access status, and description defined. As an example, interface description and interface type identifiers are provided, which are a result of MIB file parsing. Interface table excerpt is shown in table view. Table represents two interfaces with their index, description, type, speed, administrative status, and forwarded traffic metrics. Some objects have enumerated values like type and administrative status. When queried, those numbers are received as result, and after lookup in database are mapped to named values. In the bottom, full object identifiers are shown for interface description and interface type. NetSNMP command line toolset can be used to query agent. Provided command behavior will be shown in command line. In this example, we will query system description. It is a scalar value and zero should be added at the end. As a result, we received full named identifier, type, and value of the object. To get identifiers in numbered format, option should be added. Request can be made using numbered format. As system description is scalar value, missing 0 at the end will result in error. As a workaround in discovery phase, SNMP walk can be used. It runs getNext request and finds correct identifier. SNMP walk has similarity with SNMP get comment. The difference is that SNMP walk runs getNext requests and follows the tree. As a result, we are receiving objects with unique table identifiers. It is possible to query in named and numbered format. SNMP translate command can be used to translate identifiers from named format to numbered format, and vice versa. That was intro into MIB files. Thanks for watching, and if you liked the content, hit like button, and see you in the following videos.